All right, welcome guys. So today the ChatGPT-4o mini just launched, so I want to test it out. I'm just going to go with the prompt that they give us, and we're going to try to create a basic game. So it's asking me what programming language I want to use. So let's go with JavaScript, and it's giving me a couple of things. These are great. I'm just going to speed it up, but here's me answering some of the things. I really just want to create a simple quiz app for the most part, and let's see how this goes. All right. Cool. Now it's giving us more of a quest adventure type of game. Okay, so now it's saying, yep, it's getting everything right. Target audience, game mechanics. We're not really doing a game, but you know, these are some cool stuff. If I was making a real game, these are great things to look out for. Okay, so I just tell it to keep going. And then, yep, I wanted to start writing some code and let's see something. So cool. First, I'm asking it to create a question bank of just 10 questions that we can play around with. It does that, but I want it in JSON format so I can just copy and paste it nice and easy. So, yep, that one is good. Now, the fun part. This is me trying to get it to design and code it out. So it gives us three files, HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, which is perfect. So let's get into VS Code and let's start creating some files. First up, we want to create the index.html and we just want to copy and paste the code. I'm not even going to bother looking at it. I just want to see how good it does without me touching code at all. So here's me putting the styles now. And last but not least, JavaScript. Okay, here's me just double checking. Yep, it's doing script.js, so I just want to make sure the file is named correctly. Cool, with that, let's save. Let's run the live server and check it out. Nice, so we actually have a JavaScript quiz. It looks decent and it's functional. Perfect, I scored 1 out of 2. I don't know if that's correct, but yep, it works. All right, so now I'm going to copy and paste the 10 questions just to give it more questions. Nice, it's doing that. Update the styling and make it look slightly nicer in terms of rows rather than how it was positioned before. So it's actually giving me a CSS and JavaScript. And let's try getting a CSS. Cool, here's me just updating all the CSS. Already it's starting to look good and nice and nice and taking up the full row. Cool, now I want it to add some more features, such as how fast the user answered the questions. So it's telling me to update the JavaScript file. I'm not going to copy the first part, but I'm going to copy the rest of the code. Cool, it's going to add a couple of lines of code and let's try it out. Here's me just playing, clicking around. Nice, at the end it does give us a time, so perfect. Cool, now I want to create another feature. So at the end of the screen, I want to show the questions that we got wrong, as well as what the right answer is for that question. All right, first up, it's telling us we need to add some CSS, a summary CSS. That sounds true. Let's go and add that. Next up, yep, JavaScript. So let's just copy that. And hopefully this does exactly what we're looking for. I'm not gonna update that questions, but we can add more lines of code. Let's see, this is me trying to test it out. So it's not working just yet. So instead of me trying to debug, I wanna get ChatGPT to debug it. So let's go and ask it to debug its own code. Nice, so it's given us a couple of things. The first thing first is result and summary. Okay, I don't recall being a summary, so let's go and add that. Nice, this is probably it. And voila, nice. So it says we got 1 out of 10, and it's given us only 1. So there's still some more debugging to do. It's not 100% correct just yet. And let's go and ask it to debug itself one more time. So here, prompt engineering matters a little bit. You can't just tell the debug. You have to be a little more specific. So here it gives us an updated JavaScript code. Hopefully it is correct. Let's try it out. All right, now let me update the code. Let's see if it works. And nice, we do get it. So lastly, I just wanted to update the styling. Let's see if we can handle that. Cool, so that's my prompt. It gives us updated CSS. It says existing styles, so we don't want to update the whole CSS file. Gonna be have to careful with that. So here's me trying to look for that result and then put it right below it or right above it. Everything including results, I should say. Nice. Also, JavaScript needs to be updated because we are adding some styles, so something changed with this function. Okay, so let's see if that works. Let's give it a try. And nice. So we can go further, but this is where I'll stop. And I just want to say, if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to like and subscribe. This is my new channel and my only channel, so I would appreciate it if you guys supported me. But here's me just trying a couple times. It's still some bugs I noticed. We can go around and debug it and keep prompting it. But for now, this is a stopping point. This is great. So far, it's looking good. I want to try with the other models, but this is the video for today. Thank you.